My understanding of this issue is that this company illegally drilled and has been profiting since 2004 under different operators, but all the time without a permit. In October, I read in the newspaper that a city inspector found illegally dumping chemicals into Hickory Creek, which runs into Lake Louisville and becomes the drinking water of the people of Dallas. First, when confronted with that, this company said that they were pumping fresh water into that creek, but that didn't prove to be true because they then agreed to clean up 24,000 gallons of water and 48 cubic yards of dirt from the creek. So it now seems absurd to me to grant this company permission to continue what they've been doing illegally. They've lost trust with the citizens of Denton, in my opinion, and I would like them to pay the fines that they owe the city for illegally breaking, which can be up to $2,000 a day. We would also like to have the council consider a 15-foot setback, the same as Flower Mound. They have a pretty good system going there. $1,500, thank you.
I'd ask that we not have any outburst from the group. Everybody will get their time to speak if desired. And if you fill out a card, okay, please go ahead.
Sure. I also would like to just say that putting up a wall and planting flowers is frankly kind of insulting. I would rather see a warning sign about the health effects of fracking.
Thank you.
I don't really see why it's even a question of whether we should be giving a company a permit to do something that it's been doing illegally for over half a decade. It just makes no sense, and especially considering the history of what the company is. You said that the history of the company and the environmental impact of the company and everything that's surrounding what the company does to make a profit doesn't have anything to do with what we're talking about right now, but it does. If you were to go in and approve this permit, it's like enabling a child to continue doing something that has been repeatedly told, you can't do that, you can't do that, it's illegal, and you've been doing it for half a decade, and now, oh, well, okay, sure, keep on doing it. It's right next to UNT's new football stadium, which has three wind turbines on it, which are clearly there to make a point. We care about the area that we live in, we care about the environment that is around us, we care about the people in our community, and so we're putting these up. And now right next to it, then we have two fracking sites, two hydraulic fracturing sites that are damaging to the environment, are damaging to people's health, cause earthquakes that have never happened in the area before. I don't see why it's a question. I'm getting weird looks. According to a United
Mr. McBride, you're getting strange looks because you're ignoring what we had talked about. I understand your situation, but it's SUP related. Let's not talk about wind turbines on UNT campus. Let's keep it to the problems of the SUP. So please go ahead.
Okay. So I'll address something that's relevant to the SUP, and if you'll excuse me, I'd like to have a little bit of the time that you took there back. Rather than, say, an 8-foot fence blocking our being able, blocking what we can see of it, how about we put up an 8-foot billboard all the way around it and saying, hey, guess what's behind this wall? It's a fracking site. It's hydraulic fracking is going on behind this wall. How would we put that up? There's my concern with the SUP.
Has stated that this commission has the power and the right to squash this nonsensical proposal by these lawbreakers. I would like to point out that if I broke the law for 5 years and they came and asked for your approval, you would laugh me out of the room, and you should. Now, granted, considering that the citizens of this city largely oppose projects of this kind, considering that no permit was ever granted in the first place, my request, as respectfully as I can deliver it to this commission, is that not only should this permit be denied, but that every single possible fee that can possibly be levied, and every single fine and tax that can be levied against every company which ever had any relationship to an unpermitted site be levied, and also, furthermore, that it should be shut down to set an example. This is a city which doesn't tolerate companies running rampant over the citizens of the community. They proposed in their own, it was number 7 in their proposal, that they be subjected to all the relevant fines. I'd say there's one element of their proposal worth considering.
Opposed to this request. For many of the reasons that have already been mentioned, this is a company that began by breaking the law. You're talking about approving a company, and the fact that it's been sold many times, obviously the first company wanted to get this off their hands, because they must have known it was unpermitted. You don't start drilling a multi-million dollar project without a city permit, that doesn't just slip through the cracks. They did this on purpose. And now they're coming back, another company, many years after the fact, and expecting to just get rubber stamped. And that's what this is. If a bunch of us weren't sitting here at 9:30, almost 9:30 at night, saying that we oppose this, which most of the city actually, in fact, does oppose this, which is evidence that all of the public media is really fracking. If not for us being here at 9 o'clock at night, this is another rubber stamp, and that's unacceptable because these people are lawbreakers, and there's no reason to believe that they won't continue to break the law after you give them a permit. We can't trust any of the things as a. Tara Lynn said they've been caught dumping waste illegally. They're not holding themselves accountable to that. And as a city who's about to pass new regulation that many citizens are working very hard on, the idea that we can just have this little meeting and circumvent all of that effort puts the new regulation, the entire regulatory structure, in question. And it makes the city a joke. And what are drillers, what are operators going to do? They're going to come in here and say, we can drill a well, we can start poisoning people, and we'll just come back, you know, a few years down the line. They're not going to fine us. They're just going to, you know, we'll give a little 15-minute presentation, and it'll be wiped off the record. And that's completely unacceptable. The citizens oppose that. I strongly oppose that, and I hope you all do the right thing.
And as we go, we've obtained knowledge to realize that it's a little bit of a convoluted situation. So, at this time, since the public hearing is closed, we will all in favor, please raise your right hand.
Mic check.
On all